Last weekend, we looked at a living room and the kind of furniture that you need to make it functional. Today, we are going to look at the general overview of lighting your house. Do you know the kind of lights that you need for a particular space? We are going to have an expert and is going to explore whereby each one of us will get to know how you will illuminate your rooms and get that feel and that get ambience, because one thing we have learned is that lighting changes the entire place. This is the Homes and Construction Show. Join me as we learn together. Differentiate for us the different types of lighting for various locations.
We have a number of types of lighting. We have chandeliers, we have pendants, we have decorative lights, we have strips, we have spotlights, we have starlights, we have mirror lights, we have picture lights, we have step lights. All those now are in the category of interior lighting. Then when we look at exterior lighting, we look at security lights, we look at garden lights, we look at paper lights, we look at flower lights. That is the category when it comes to the exterior lighting. Yeah. Now, what does it take, or what determines which light you put where? First and foremost, I think one of the things we don't usually do is we do not plan our lighting. We are supposed to design the kind of lighting that you want at the type at the time when the architecture is designing your home.
Really?
Actually, that is the time when you have to visualize the kind of lighting that you are going to put in your home. When you visualize that lighting, then it will give you the kind of ceiling you're going to put into your house. Because now, someone who is thinking about decorative lighting, you really have to think about that first ceiling. That is the ceiling that you use gypsum boards.
True.
Now, when you're thinking about spotlights, you have to think about it too. Because such kind of lights are supposed to be put in a place where you don't, when it's not so hard. Actually, the difference between the first ceiling and the concrete ceiling is that the concrete ceiling is so hard. If you're going to cut it to put all the different designs, much as it can be done, but it takes a lot of cost.
And it may not come out perfectly.
Exactly.
Like, well.
And it may not do that. So that is one of the things. Those are some of the things that you need to. But for you to do that, you need to have visualized your kind of lighting at that time, in that the architecture is able to put it on the design, on the plan. And then you're able to do it at that later stage. So it's one of the things. Then one of the other things that determine the kind of lighting that we are going to have is the tasks. There are things that we have to look at before you decide which kind of lighting you're going to have. For instance, what tasks are you going to do in that place? In the modern world, we no longer use the, what do they call it, that lamp holder and the bulb.
Really?
Yeah. Now, if you're still using the lamp holder and the bulb, you're still in that analog world. But if you're going to go with the digital world, we are no longer using that. We use the lighting equipment. And when you're choosing your equipment, the first thing that comes into mind has to be beauty.
Lighting equipment, you mean what?
Now, lighting equipment are the different types of lights that we have. Like a chandelier, it's a lighting equipment. A pendant is a lighting equipment.
A strip?
It's also lighting equipment. All these are different lighting equipment. So what does it take for you to decide that here I'm going to put a chandelier, here I'm going to put spotlights, here it depends on the tasks that you do in a room.
In other words, various locations determine the type of lighting to have in a home.
Exactly. For instance, if you're going to read, say like you're designing, now let's design a sitting room.
True.
One of the things that we do in the sitting rooms, we read. The other thing that we do is you can decide to take a cup of tea. You can decide to watch a movie in your sitting room. You can just decide to just chill with your kids or your friends in your sitting room. Now, we are talking about four different tasks.
In one space.
And we can decide to allocate four different types of lights in that space.
Really?
Yes. Now, what are you going to do? Now, for instance, you're going to decide that I'm going to put a centerpiece. You make sure that centerpiece is giving you quite good light for you to be able to read. Now you get to know that whenever I want to read, what am I going to use? I'll use the centerpiece. So you design the centerpiece with that light. For instance, we will say that when you put in the bulbs, don't put in cool white or that yellow, the yellowish bulbs. No,
that
put in daylight bulbs.
Daylight bulbs in a scenario where we're using a centerpiece.
A centerpiece. Why are you putting in daylight bulbs? Because you are going to use that particular type of lighting for reading. That is, if you're going to read your newspapers, you will know that when I'm going to read, I'll put on the centerpiece. And that is what. Now, if you're going to say, like, chill with your friends in your sitting room, then you will need the strip light. Because this is now the kind of light which is not too much. It's just giving
subtle.
You... Yeah. So you will use the strip light. If you're going to take a cup of tea, then you will use the decorative lights. Why? You're taking your cup of tea. When you look up at your ceiling, it's something that is desirable to look at and admirable. So in such a scenario, you will only use the decorative lights or the recessed lights. It depends on what, all the spotlights. It depends on what you have put in your sitting room. Then, if you're going to watch a movie,
true.
Then you design that kind of light. You can, for instance, add the strip and the wall washers, and then it will be able to bring you a movie-like mood. Then you will now have put a movie-like mood, in that you'll switch off all the bright lights, and then you switch on that movie-like mood light.
So ideally, lights change according to someone's mood.
Exactly.
Now, must we have lights everywhere?
I think so.
Do we need to have lights everywhere?
For beauty? Yes.
Because when you're giving us classifications, you mentioned quite a number of areas and spaces for lights.
Yes.
So a question came in that do we need lights everywhere? Garden, pavers.
Let me tell you one thing about lighting. Lighting makes the beauty of a place. Actually, when you put, for instance, now like the garden lights, when you put them there, my God, you feel this mood. You feel like it gives you this ambience that you really want to be in your garden. There's so many people, I don't know whether you've noticed, where people want to spend time in places that look nice.
Everyone wants to spend time in a very amazing looking place.
I'll give you one of the trading statements that World Ventures used to use. Or they are still using it. When someone is marketing World Venture, they will always tell you, oh my God, you'll be able to sleep in a 5-star hotel. But have you ever sat down and thought about what makes a 5-star hotel? I've looked at everything that makes 5-star hotels.
Maybe the service, the location.
We shall look at all that. It will.
Hey.
But the most outstanding thing that makes a 5-star hotel are the lights. Oh my God, when you reach, I don't know whether when you travel, especially in these countries that we traveled to, say Dubai, India, most of these countries we reach there in the night, or we live in the night. When you look at those places, you will see the most fancy, beautiful places.
At night.
But what makes that?
The light.
It's only the light. When you look at, when you're landing, you look at these very different types of lights. They are sometimes blue, green, and you're like, wow. But if those lights were out, trust me, that place would be so
becomes normal.
Very normal. So lighting makes it, it brings out too much that we wouldn't even expect it to bring out. So at the end of the day, even when you have very bad tiles, even when you have bad curtains or bad furniture, but your lighting will bring out these things to look very beautiful. So it's very important. You do not have to put lights when you really think that sometimes it's only the pocket. But if it's not the pocket, trust me, when you put these lights, they might, especially when you consider beauty, they will bring out your place to be very, very executive. That when you first, before you switch on that light, it should be very beautiful. It should be able to say something before you switch it on. Now, when you switch it on, then it just adds on the beauty that we are able to see when it was off. Now it is on, it should add more value to what it was when it was off.
Ideally, lighting adds more value
exactly
to a space
exactly
or a property
exactly.
Now I'm going to take you back. You mentioned earlier about where people really need to start thinking of their lighting, so I need us to dive deeper into it so that everyone grasps it very well. At what stage of construction should one consider lighting?
Actually, one should consider lighting the very time you think about building your house. Most of the time, actually, we will think about, and then you'll be able to see, I want my sitting room to look like this, I want the bedroom to be like this, I want the wardrobes to be here. That is the same time you have to have visualized the kind of lighting that you want. Now, when you visualize the kind of lighting at that stage, then when you're talking to your architecture, now she is designing, he or she is designing your plan. The architecture should be in position to put the kind of lighting on your
drawings
at that time. What does it help you? It helps you to put all the necessary points at the time of building to eliminate the breaking. Because if you don't, and at that time, at that stage when you reach and you want to put the lighting, and then you say, oh no, but I want the strip lights. No, you did not design the strip lights in your building. So what does it mean? It will mean that you're going to break.
To fit it.
And the worst part about it is that you might not be able to put that particular type of lighting that you want. Now, for instance, you will have maybe given your ceiling maybe a distance that won't be in position to hold the kind of light that you want. For instance, a chandelier. There are those dropping chandeliers. If your ceiling is short, then you will have missed it out.
So for instance, what distance or what space does one need to have to plan for a chandelier?
Now, you see, if you plan that with your architecture,
yes,
they will be able to give you enough space from the ground to the ceiling, knowing that here we want a dropping light. So in that moment, the time when the architecture is designing, they'll be in position to give the necessary space for you to hold your chandelier at the time when you're going to fit it in.
Isn't it time consuming and costs the costs really that we will get involved in, especially when you engage the architect on your lights, won't it be affected by the trends? Because we know how the trends move, work. Maybe by the time I reach at the lighting bit, the styles have changed. So what do you say about that?
No, the trends, actually, the drawing does not affect the trends.
I'm thinking perhaps I the time I got the drawings, the gypsum boards are, maybe by that time the gypsum boards were spot on, were a thing, were an item, were on vogue. Now, maybe I've taken 2 years or 3 years. You know, challenges come up every other day. And here we've reached a stage of having our lights fitted. And you find maybe that that one is now an analog way of building or construction. Isn't it also going to be a problem? Because I see that one will be even forced to break.
Now, let me tell you one thing about if you have put your lighting into your drawing. If you reach at that time and you find yourself that, okay, no, I don't need the gypsum board, it won't affect it. But if you did not design the gypsum board and you reach at that time and you want the gypsum board, then it will affect
because you have to have it affected.
Exactly. First and foremost, like I've told you, the height, maybe the height that was given to your ceiling is so low that you can now not fit in this particular lights that you want. And maybe you did not create the points. Now I'll give you like certain points that we always forget. Many of us want picture lights, but we never have those points. Why?
Picture lights.
Because you did not even imagine a picture light at that time.
Wait a minute. Why would I need a picture light at my home if I'm not having a studio, a photo studio?
It flashes on the you know, we put pictures, our wedding pictures, our children's pictures, our, you know, but it will flash and it will make it, it will reflect on it and it will look very nice. Then you might find that you want a mirror light, but you never even gave that point at that time of building. But because you have visualized your light at the time of doing your drawings, then you'll be able to put in all these necessary points. Sometimes, and it doesn't actually, it doesn't have any problem if you didn't use these points. You can even decide to use these points at a later date, because maybe by the time you're finishing the house, you really want to get in and the money is not there. But at a later date, the money comes in. Then you come back and do what you have to do. But because you designed and you put the point there, then it will be easy for you to put it there. And remember that these houses are, you know, like there's this home improvement, maintenance. Every time you can make your house better. So what you did not put at the original time, you can put it at a certain time. Why? Because
it was incorporated already in the drawings.
Yeah. So it's very, very important. There are some of the things that we do not even have to think twice about. Please, while you're going to build your house, visualize the kind of lighting that you want. Lighting at the end of the day makes the beauty of a place. Let no one lie to you. Yeah. And then, you know, when you sit in your sitting room and you say, like, I'm lying down, you should be in position to look at something
within your space.
I can show you now, like, if we looked at that light, just look at the design that it gives you.
I know.
It is something worthwhile looking at and kind of driving out any other negative thought
that could be on your mind.
It even makes you make money, by the way.
Yeah. Talk about that bit of making money. How will that make me make money?
You know, whenever you are in a space admirable to look at, whenever you are in a space that really makes you feel at home, trust me, the ideas of money making will just flow into your mind. Yeah. And then before you know it, you don't know that beautiful light is what is making you pave way to other things. Yeah.
So in that case, does one really need an expert to guide them on lighting their buildings?
Exactly. You need an expert. Why? An expert will be able to look at a light. For instance, like people who have small spaces, one would come and say, me, I want a chandelier here. When I come to you, I'll tell you, yeah, much as you want this chandelier here, but it won't look nice. And then we'll be able to give you options of other lights that you would use that would fit in that space and would look nice in that space. We have chandeliers, by the way, which are more like ceiling chandeliers. It just fits up there. Exactly. It doesn't drop. Yeah, it doesn't.
Aye.
Now, There are other things that you would also need to know. For instance, when you want, maybe like there are so many people, when it comes to spotlights, they put so many of them.
Those spotlights.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Too much of anything is always bad. Mm. So we'll be able to advise you that no, much as you put all these spotlights, they won't look nice. Mm. The fewer they are, the better. Yeah, the fewer they are, the better. But you find that somebody puts in spotlights and they are all so close to one another, it doesn't look as nice as when they are few.
Mm.
Yeah. So it depends on the space. You look at the space and then you see, okay, we can put three here, we can put three there, and then we can leave other places vacant. Mm. It will look very nice. And then executive. You would really know that this lighting was done with somebody who really knows what lighting is. And then when you go to places where it is everywhere, then you'll know that no, the person was only doing.
Does that mean that the lighting of a building or a home can tell you more about one's style?
Exactly. And many of the people actually who really do this executive lighting, they've either traveled a lot.
Now that is it. Because one cannot have an inspiration when they have not seen it. It's so hard for someone to envision.
Mm.
And this is where maybe most of our people go wrong, because they'll be like, this is what I want.
Mm.
Much as they've not seen it anywhere.
Exactly.
But you see, when you travel, I think the inspirations change, kind of.
Okay,
that is true. You can pick a few.
Yeah, but now, you know, the world has gone digital.
Mm.
That we sit down and you're able to see those flashy houses out there and their kind of lighting.
Mm.
Yeah, so much as you might not have traveled,
mm.
you know, there are people you would see, especially people who love quality, but you fall in that category of interior designers. Now, interior designers is wide.
Mm.
It would mean somebody who can come in and design for you your curtains, your furniture, your lighting, your what. Particularly as we are only in lighting. Only lighting.
We specialize in lighting. Where do we find them? Because you see, like, these other ones have boards. They have boards that are governing them.
Mm-hmm.
They have, you can easily type, like, go on Google,
mm-hmm.
then find their names, their
mm-hmm.
email addresses, their contacts.
Mm-hmm.
Where do we find these interior designers that specify in lighting?
In lighting. Actually, for us, we don't have a board.
Mm.
We don't have a board. You know, there are certain things that come to you as a skill. You have it as a skill. And then because of the quality, the admiration, the desire,
mm.
that we ended up into the lighting business.
Mm.
And now we went further to train ourselves, because we always have exhibition in German every after 2 years.
Mm.
We go in and then we help ourselves to even become better with our lighting skills, to make sure that we are online with what is trending.
Mm.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Annette, because you've opened our eyes. I believe everyone has benefited and they're still learning about lighting. To you, our viewers, you have heard it. Now, we learned today that we have analog, we have digital. Some of you are still actually stuck in analog if you did not know when it comes to lighting. So, lighting as a topic, you've seen it is so broad, it is so wide, we can't finish it just in a few minutes or seconds. This is why we promise to bring you always the best. We are going to tell you that we have an expert next week again to tell us more about these updatings. They have to go to Germany to update. By the way, how can you find out a genuine interior designer that specifies or that is specifically handling lighting? Don't miss next weekend. I really thank you so much for being with us today. and we are still bringing you more. My name is Hilda Kankaba, and this has been the Homes and Construction Show. Have a good night.